mini instructionals here on YouTube. Today I'm going to do an intermediate advanced belly dance little combo type movement, and it's going to start with the Carmen Miranda step. So I'm not sure if you all know this, but basically Carmen Miranda is out with your hip up, over, out, over, out, over, out, over. I'll do it the other way too, okay? So you can follow me. So you're going out, over, out, over, out, over, out, over, out, over, out. So that's Carmen Miranda. This is a nice step you can just do with some arms, or these arms. So what I've done, I've turned it into the Carmen Mayada. That's right. So my students gave this name to this step. It's awesome. And basically you're adding a Maya movement. So a figure, some people call these figure eights, vertical figure eights or something like that. I call them Mayas. So it's a figure eight on the wall or the mirror in front of you. Okay. So make sure you have really great technique in your Mayas, and maybe I'll do an instructional clip of that soon. So Mayas are basically going up, out, and then down into a slide drop. Up, out, down, up, out, down. And you want to keep your abs as tight as possible throughout that. Okay, so there's the Maya. Now we're going to add that into the Carmen Miranda to make the Carmen Mayada. So we're going to start here. And we're gonna go up, out, down. Make sure your hip goes right down and your abs are tight. And then you're gonna do another Maya on this side. Up, out, down. Then you're gonna cross over. Up, out, down. 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 Let me turn around so we can do it together this way. Here we go. Maya, step Maya, Maya as you cross over. Maya, Maya, Maya. Make sure that hip is getting right down, 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 and that your abs are nice and tight throughout this whole motion. You don't want your bum sticking out like this through it. It looks like this then. Okay, that's not a good look. Okay, so make sure you're here, tight abs, Maya, 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 and down, down, down. You don't want to be up here, up, up, up with your bum out, okay? So make sure you're getting that nice down. If you're not, you need to practice your Mayas more, your figure eights, and just really work on that slide drop. My students know I'm obsessed with these slide drops. Maybe I should do a clip of those for sure. Here we go. And Maya, Maya, Maya. Maya, Maya, Maya. Maya, Maya. Really sink down at the end of the Maya and keep those abs nice and tight. Okay, so now we're ready to add something else, right? You've perfected that? Awesome. So now we add a little isolated hip circle. So that's side, front with the pelvis, side with the hip, back. Side, front, side, back. This type of little hip circle. I do have an instructional clip somewhere breaking this down a bit. So look for that. Anyway, so small hip circle. What we're going to do, we're going to do the Maya. Maya as you step out, Maya to change weight, and then you're going to do a little hip circle, back, side, front. You don't quite finish it off, you're at front, and then you're going to go Maya, the other side, Maya, Maya, back, side, front, hip circle, Maya, Maya, hip circle, Maya, Maya, hip circle, Maya, Maya, hip circle, Maya, Maya, hip circle. I'm going to turn around and show you from this way. So we're here, step out, Maya, Maya, back, side, front with the hip circle. Into Maya, Maya, back, side, front. So you're alternating the direction of the hip circle every time. It's going towards your next Maya, Maya. hip circle. And Maya, Maya, hip circle. And Maya, Maya, hip circle. And Maya, Maya, hip circle. Let's try that with music now. Here we go. Facing you first, so be my mirror image when you're practicing. Ready, and Maya, Maya, hip. Maya, Maya, hip. Maya, Maya, hip. Keep the upper body nice and calm. Hip. Maya, Maya, and now turn around. Maya, Maya, hip. Maya, Maya, hip. Maya, Maya, hip. Go for it. And of course you can get fast with it, okay? So here we are, and Maya, Maya, hip.
And that you'll practice your Carmen Mayadas and Carmen Mayadas with little hip circles in the middle. So I'm planning on doing this on a more regular basis, so hopefully once a week or every 2 weeks I'll get a new combo or step out to you guys. And I just wanted to talk a little bit about my theory on stuff like this. So a lot of people know me for all my crazy, cool combination steps like this one, and others that get a little more wild. So I am known for that, and I love them, but I do want to stress that you have to be really great at those basic steps, right? I use these combo steps sometimes just as a way to force people to want to practice those basic steps. So a lot of people misunderstand my theory and think, oh, I'm all about fast stuff and new stuff and crazy combos and this and that, but really, I believe belly dancers need amazing basic steps, okay? It's the most important thing. Look at any of the classics. Look at all the famous belly dancers from the 70s, 60s, 50s. What do? They don't do all these crazy combos. No, they do 32 counts of undulates. They do shimmies for 5 minutes. They do beautiful hip kick. So having those basic steps, undulate, hip kick, hip accent, shimmies, there's some more, hip circles, backwards figure eights, these types of things that you learned in beginner belly dance, so important. And when I perform, those are the majority of the movements that I do. I don't bust out a million crazy combos all at one time, unless I've kind of choreographed the dance and I'm trying to impress belly dancers, maybe. But when I'm improvising, it's mainly undulate, shimmy, backwards figure eight. You know, I have my favorites, but that's what comes out, and they need to be quality. So with these combos, it's great because you can practice those steps within a combo. So keep you interested as an advanced dancer, but be practicing those basic steps. Don't let them go away. Don't think, oh, I have that. You know, I teach advanced students, I'm always correcting their shimmy walk. Shimmy walk, you know, you learn that in beginner usually. Shimmy walk is one of the most people lose it as they go. They just kind of like, oh, yeah, okay, shimmy walk, I know that. So always be looking back. Try a beginner class again. Even if you're a professional dancer, it's great to go back and practice those basic movements to make sure that you have them 100% and you look grounded and amazing, and just you can shock people with those belly rolls and huge shimmies and stuff like that. So definitely learn all my crazy cool combos, but make sure you're making sure, like for example with this step, make sure that you have an amazing figure eight or Maya as you're doing that Carmen Mayada, right? Maybe take it back a step and work on your Mayas a bit. And then make sure you have an amazing isolated hip circle, right? And then do it all together and go slowly and just make sure you're getting all those movements. Not that you're like, oh my god, yeah, it's a figure eight and a little hip circle and I'm good. And then you just look flailing and crazy. So you want to make sure you're grounded. You want to make sure you have those steps. Let's keep it real, belly dancers. Have great technique, practice the basics, and then have fun with the combos. Okay, I'll see you here soon. Check out www.mayada.ca for everything I'm up to, and classes, and workshops, and events, and photos, and videos, all that stuff. And yeah, stay tuned. Thanks for watching.